Pam Geller, today's worst person in the world. Not really.
On the cutting edge of the defense against the spread of elements of Islamic law in the United States. And for her efforts in defense of human rights, in defense of America, defense of Israel, defense of Judeo-Christian civilization, she has been demonized, ridiculed, mocked, and of course, threatened with death. And yet, she has never given up and never will give up. Even Annie Taylor said, nobody should ever do that again. But the next winner of this award keeps on doing it. She has taken the battle to the Islamic supremacists in the United States and put them on the defensive like nobody ever has before, calling attention to the human rights abuses that are inherent in Islamic law in unprecedented and imaginative ways that have brought national attention that has never before been directed to subjects like honor killing, the death penalty for apostasy, and of course, the sinister intent behind the Ground Zero Mosque. She created and placed all over the country bus ads that offered help to people who were leaving Islam. They were, as the media always does, distort the truth. They were mischaracterized as asking people to leave Islam or inviting them to do so. Actually, this was a real offer for help for people that the whole world has ignored. Islam mandates a death penalty for apostasy. Muhammad said, if anybody changes his religion, kill him. But nobody ever cares for those people. Have you ever heard Amnesty International or Human Rights Watch say a word about apostates from Islam who are under the threat of death every day of their lives? She brought national attention to this issue, and never before had the Islamic supremacists group like the Council on American Islamic Relations, never before had they experienced this kind of pushback. Never before had they been put on the defensive, and the campaign was brilliantly conceived, because if you think about it, what could CARE say? Well, actually, yes, we do think the apostates should be killed. We don't think that people who are threatened ought to be offered help. Never before had their agenda and their pseudo-moderation been so thoroughly and completely exposed. She put ads on taxi tops with pictures of beautiful young girls who had been murdered by their families for besmirching the Islamic honor of their families. And you know, you hear about honor killings and you hear about statistics and people say, well, you know, 91% of the honor killings in the world take place in Islamic contexts, and these things are justified by various rulings in Islamic law. But 91% is a number. Never before had public attention been brought to, these are girls, these are human beings. These are people that ought to have been saved and protected. And here again, this kind of thing had never been attempted before. All the time, the groups like CARE are on the offensive and are making us play catch up and react to them. Never before had they been put on the defensive. And of course, the crowning, the culmination of all this was how she made the Ground Zero Mosque a matter of national discussion and shone a light on the Imam Faisal Abdul Rauf's pro-Sharia activities, his denial of basic freedoms in the United States, his call for restrictions on freedom of speech, his ties to the jihad flotilla against Israel, and so many other things, such that Daisy Khan, his wife, identified the next winner as being the leader of the opposition to the mosque. And then the Islamic attack machine went into high gear. She became a lightning rod for abuse from the left, from the mainstream media, and it continues. It continues on a more or less daily basis. I remember seeing an attack piece in a major publication and thinking, well, you know, these things are going to happen with the left controlling the media. And then the next day there was another, and another, and another, one after the other. And just a couple nights ago, you may have seen the illustrious Keith Olbermann named her the worst person in the world. Actually, for a controversy she had nothing to do with. But now she's a symbol, you know? A symbol of freedom and a symbol that we will never give up. And so, you know the old saying, if you're getting flack, you know you're over the target. If they're screaming, you know they're hitting them hard. And she never gives up and continues to work with passionate vision, insight, immense love for the West, for America, for Israel, for civilization. We live in so cheap and tawdry an age that all you have to do to be a hero today is tell the truth. And yet there are so few heroes. Because if you dare to tell the truth, you will be made to pay a very great price. And yet, the next winner of this award is someone who has paid it, and paid it with great courage and with a great joy in life that is an inspiration to me personally. In my work with her, it is my great pleasure and honor, therefore, to present the Annie Taylor Award to a true hero, a great warrior for the right, whom I am proud to say is my friend and colleague, Pamela Geller.